It was Vietnam first, then it was Cambodia, today it's Afghanistan. The United States enters war but does not complete them. It claims victory halfway through, then it runs away. America's enemies end up winning the war. This has become an all too familiar trend now. The art of running has been perfected by the United States. It has left Afghanistan in disarray. The Taliban has taken control of Kabul. The Islamic Emirate of Afghanistan is back, and it is a major regional threat. The US should just stop waging wars across the world. It has lost its shine. It's not all that powerful after all. It lacks strategy. It lacks decisiveness. Hi and welcome. This is TFI English, the national socio-political analysis arm of the TFI Media Group. I'm your host Tribhuvan, and in this video, I will tell you about America's history of running away from war zones, whether it be Vietnam or Afghanistan. Let's begin. It was Saigon then. After waging a 19-year-long war against the Vietnamese communists, the United States decided to withdraw. 2 years after the withdrawal of American troops, Saigon, now known as Ho Chi Minh City, was taken over by the communists, and the United States was left befuddled. It desperately scrambled to evacuate American citizens from the country in 1975. Not much has changed ever since. Joe Biden's disastrous, ill-planned and hasty withdrawal from Afghanistan is forcing a repeat of Saigon and the horrors of Vietnam once again. Americans are desperately trying to leave Afghanistan as the US tries to fit in all of its citizens like a cattle in humongous aircraft. The American embassy in Afghanistan has shut down. Such desperate scenes would not have been panned out had the Biden administration thought the US withdrawal from Afghanistan through. It did not, and today the United States is facing global ridicule for leaving a war-torn country in the hands of Islamist extremists who will take Afghanistan back to the horrifying time of their early rule. In 2001, the Taliban was ousted from power by US troops. Afghans breathed a sign of relief. 20 years later, Afghanistan has reverted to square one. In fact, Cambodia too, in 1987, witnessed the best of America's run, in which we mean the Asian country saw how the US, which prides itself to be the leader of the free world, withdraw from the country with its tail between its legs. The United States in the past 20 years has spent $3 trillion on Afghanistan. 2,41,000 people have been killed in the Afghan war. 2,442 US soldiers have lost their lives. More than 20,000 US soldiers have been wounded. An additional $90 billion was spent trying to prepare the Afghan forces for battle against the Taliban. Today, all sacrifices made by American soldiers and all of Americans' tax money spent on Afghanistan has gone down the drain. It has amounted to absolutely nothing. Kabul has fallen. The Taliban have taken control of Afghanistan. Photos from the presidential palace in Afghanistan show Talibani savages in their medieval outfit, reciting the Quran while being armed with guns. Afghanistan's civilian government, led by President Ashraf Ghani and Vice President Amrullah Saleh, has fled the country. They would not have been forced to flee had the Biden administration not made wrecking Afghanistan a priority. Make no mistake, the US had to withdraw from Afghanistan eventually. It was known to all and that they had the right to do so. The US cannot and should not fight the wars of other countries. However, after having waged a 20-year-long war against the Taliban, the least that the Biden administration should have done is ensured that the organization does not ride back to the power days after the withdrawal of US troops. The Taliban is back in Kabul, and Joe Biden's disastrous withdrawal policy is squarely to be blamed for it. The joke doing the rounds in India is that Kamala Harris would now truly be telling the US president, "We did it, Joe." During the Soviet invasion of Afghanistan in 1980s, the United States had given birth to the Taliban. In order to counter Soviet influence over Afghanistan, Washington weaponized the country's Islamist warlords, who went through several phases of groupings before eventually metamorphosizing into dreaded Taliban, which publicly executes people, molests women, sees imposition of Sharia law in its cruelest form, and takes back Afghanistan by centuries. What the US gave rise to when Afghanistan was a snake, which came to bite Washington's head once it grew too powerful. The US invaded Afghanistan after the 9/11 attacks and dislodged Taliban from power. 20 years later, the Taliban should have reduced to mere memory and a relic of the past. However, the Islamist organization is stronger than it has ever been. It has once again taken control of Afghanistan. The US has failed miserably in Afghanistan. Of course, Pakistan, a country which the US trusted for too long as a partner which was helping Washington fight the Taliban, ended up double-crossing. Former President Donald Trump seized all aid to Pakistan for its dirty game against American interests in Afghanistan. That policy, if continued by Joe Biden, would have weakened the Taliban. Pakistan is the patron of Taliban. Weakening Pakistan would have directly impacted the Taliban. Joe Biden has 4 years in the office. Why the man was in such a dying hurry to evacuate from Afghanistan gives us a complete mess. Within his first year in office, Joe Biden has given rise to a disaster. Taliban has become a regional threat now, and US's callousness is to be blamed for the same. The United States enters wars bombastically, thinking it's almighty and powerful. However, historically, the US has perfected the art of losing wars and withdrawing from them in haste, with scant regard for the geopolitical ramification of its actions. Whether it be Vietnam or Afghanistan, the ability of America to run is unparalleled.